Thank you, Cathaoirleach, and I welcome the opportunity to contribute to the debate today on the renewal of certain sections of the Offences Against the State Act and Section 8 of the Criminal Justice Act as well. Minister, just in relation to the Offences Against the State Act, I agree with the previous speaker that the Act in its entirety should be repealed, and I don't believe that there's any room for special legislation such as this to be in use in a democratic society, and in a society that respects the human rights, civil liberties and due process of citizens. And under the Offences Against the State Act, we have the Special Criminal Court, which has been used, which is a court that was established to guarantee convictions. And that's the only reason that the Special Criminal Court was set up, to ensure that people who were brought before it would be convicted and sent to jail for long terms. And having mechanisms such as this undermines the human rights and the civil liberties of all citizens of the state, because it shows that the state is willing to go to extraordinary powers to deal with people that it views as being contrary to their own ethos, and undermines citizens' rights right across the country. And the operation of the Offences Against the State Act goes the same way. And his dissenting view on the review of the Terrorism Act, Professor Wall, said there's a tendency for these provisions to be used by the state for ulterior motives. And there's also has been and continues to be a tendency to broaden out the use of these measures. I mean, if you look at the report laid before the Houses in relation to the Offences Against the State Act, last year 331 people were arrested under Section 30 of the Act. Now, do we know who those 331 people were? What reasons was it used for? For example, were people associated with protesting against the Corrib gas installation, were they used, was Section 30 used against them? And you have said in your own contribution that it's used regularly by the Gardaí. But when you have those provisions there and those measures there, the tendency is to overuse them. And because they are convenient and they're easy to use, they will be overused, and they'll be used against people who aren't involved in so-called terrorism activity or aren't involved in trying to subvert the state, but maybe who are people who are using the genuine democratic process to oppose and to protest against actions that the state and private companies are doing. So having measures like this and using them in such a way and using them widely undermines everybody's civil rights and civil liberties. And some of the provisions there, like the extension of the right of detention to 72 hours under the Act, actually shows, I think, that it's used and will be used in such a way as to intimidate people into actually making confessions or whatever. And it's interesting that studies have shown that most confessions take place within the first 12 hours of detention. So the fact of having extending it to 72 hours doesn't really serve any purpose other than to try and restrict people or use it as a way of restricting people from what might be peaceful protest or might be legitimate protest as well. And the Gardaí already have adequate powers under other provisions of the Criminal Justice Act to actually deal with a lot of the offences that are included in the Offences Against the State Act. But the problem with those powers is probably that they're subject to too much overview and there's a lot of the regulation which is necessary to protect civil rights and the use of them and the action in pursuing them. So I think that this motion should be opposed. I think that the Offences Against the State Act should be repealed in its entirety, and we should be building and showing to people and citizens that the state respects human rights, respects civil liberties, and will work within due process to ensure that people's rights will be maintained. And it's by doing that the state actually shows that there is no need for subversion or there is no need for so-called terrorist organisations to try and overthrow the state when the state actually respects the citizens that it sets out to look after. In relation to Section 8 of the Criminal Justice Act, I think the same reason holds, and the same reason is there of the use of the Special Criminal Court to try cases. A court that has been established to secure convictions, and that's the reason that it's been used. And while many of the crimes that the organised criminals are involved in are apparent to everybody in society, and we've seen evidence of that in the last week, I just question how useful it has been using the Special Criminal Court. We certainly don't seem to have seen any dilution of the activities of organised criminal gangs. So we need to find other ways, and we need to find other ways to deal with these issues.
Deputy,
and I think
your time is up.
There within the Act.